Hi, I'm Dr. Ömer Toprak. I'm the head of Balıkesir University School of Medicine, Division of Nephrology, Turkey. In this cross-sectional study, we investigated the effect of magnesium levels on erectile dysfunction in elderly patients with chronic kidney disease patients. Sexuality is a significant quality of life consideration for all individuals, older adults included. Erectile dysfunction is a condition in which a man is persistent unable to attain and or maintain penile erection sufficient for sexual intercourse and is the most common sexual dysfunctions in men worldwide. Erectile dysfunction affects only 4% of men in their 50s but almost 50% over the age of 75 and up to 90% of elderly men with chronic kidney disease patients have erectile dysfunction. Erectile dysfunction may result from psychologic, neurologic, hormonal, arterial or cavernosal impairment or from a combination of these factors. There is a close relationship between erectile dysfunction, endothelial dysfunction and decreased production of nitric oxide. Magnesium is essential for metabolism of nitric oxide, which helps penile erection. Therefore, hypomagnesemia may link to erectile dysfunction. There is little information about serum magnesium levels on erectile dysfunction. We hypothesized that hypomagnesemia would increase the erectile dysfunction rates. The present study is the first to determine the prevalence and severity of erectile dysfunction in elderly hypomagnesemic patients with moderately to severely reduced kidney function. Also, in our study, we found that the prevalence and severity of erectile dysfunction were higher among hypomagnesemic subjects compared to those with normal magnesemics. The erectile dysfunction prevalence was 93.3% in hypomagnesemic patients versus 70.8% in normal magnesemic patients. Also, a significantly greater proportion of patients with hypomagnesemia had severe erectile dysfunction and mild to moderate erectile dysfunction when we compare with normal magnesemic patients. In univariate and multivariate analyses, we found that hypomagnesemia, age equal or over 70 years, proteinuria, smoking, C-reactive protein, abdominal obesity and hypertension were predictors of erectile dysfunction. And using the ROC curve analysis, we found that serum magnesium level equal or less than 1.85 mg deciliter was the best cutoff point for prediction of erectile dysfunction. The another important point is, in patients with hypomagnesemia, the levels of proteinuria, C-reactive protein, were significantly high. A significantly greater proportion of patients with hypomagnesemia had abdominal obesity, metabolic syndrome, and increased waist circumference. High-density lipoprotein, cholesterol, and albumin were significantly low in hypomagnesemics. High prevalence of abdominal obesity, proteinuria, and increased CRP levels in hypomagnesemics may explain the high risk of erectile dysfunction. Finally, our data support that erectile dysfunction is related with hypomagnesemia. Detecting the serum magnesium level in non-diabetic elderly men with chronic kidney disease seems to be a useful guide to assess the risk for erectile dysfunction. Serum magnesium measurement is an easily available and inexpensive marker. Correction of hypomagnesemia may lead to improvement in erectile function.